Let's start with scalar multiplication. We're going to look at this both algebraically and graphically. So given a vector v and scalar k, then to multiply the vector by that scalar, you just multiply the horizontal component by that scalar and the vertical component by that scalar. It's so easy. It's basically distribution. So if we start with vector v, we had a horizontal component of -3 and a vertical component of 1. To find each scalar multiple, here's what we do. For the first one, we would do 2. The scalar of 2 times -3, 1, which is going to be -6, 2. Now, looking at our second example, there are actually two different things that are happening whenever we have a scalar of -1/2. There's the effect that the 1/2 has, and there's the effect that the -1 has. But we'll talk about those when we look at it graphically. For now, let's just do our distribution. So if I do -1/2 times -3, 1, that's going to give me a horizontal component of +3/2 because a negative times a negative is a positive. And it's going to give us a vertical component of -1/2. Let's look at what this looks like graphically. I'm going to graph our original vector. I'm going to do it right here in purple. And it's going to be -3, 1. The component form of the vector doesn't tell us where the initial point is. It just says that from wherever we start, it moves to the left 3 and up 1. So I can place this vector in standard position if I want to. The scalar of 2 is actually just going to stretch out that vector. It's going to make it twice as long. If you multiply that purple vector by 2, you get the red vector. As we've shown, it has a horizontal component of -6 and a vertical component of 2, but that's how you do it graphically. You just stretch it out and make it twice as long. Now, down here in our second example, there's actually two different things that are happening. We have the effect of the negative and the effect of the 1/2. So let's see what happens here. So if I go to the right 3/2, which is 1.5, and down 1/2, it's going to put us right there. There is our vector from question B. So the negative actually flipped it to go in the opposite direction. It reflected your vector. And then the 1/2 compressed your vector. It shrunk it down. So there's a few different effects it has, but we should, after doing the slide, be able to do scalar multiplication both algebraically and graphically. Let's look at vector addition and subtraction. We're going to do algebraically on this slide, and then we're going to do graphically on the next slide. Let's say we have vector v and vector w as shown here. Find vector v plus w. Well, you're in luck. This is the easiest thing ever. All I'm going to do to find the horizontal component of my resultant vector is I'm just going to add the horizontal components of the original two vectors. So I'm going to do -3 + 2 for the horizontal component, and then I'm going to do 5 + 4 for the vertical component. So -3 + 2 is -1, and then the vertical component is 9. So that's the sum of your two vectors. Now let's subtract. We're doing vector w minus vector v. Well, you may be able to guess what we're doing here. All I'm going to do is I'm going to take vector w's horizontal component, and I'm going to subtract vector v's horizontal component. So I'm going to do 2, and don't be careful here, -3. And then for our vertical component, we're going to do 4 - 5. And so our resultant vector in this case would be 5, because -3 is +3, -1. So that's how to add and subtract vectors algebraically. It's so easy. Let's look at what it is graphically. So when we add vectors graphically, this is kind of interesting. Here's what happens. I'm going to draw both vector v and vector w. Okay, I've got everything graphed and color-coded. I have vector v and vector w. Vector v is shown in purple. Vector w is shown in red. And we're going to add these two vectors graphically. Well, here's what we can do. Basically, if I start with vector v, I can place it wherever I want. Once again, the component form doesn't tell us where the vector is located, so I'm going to place it with the initial point on the origin. In layman's terms, I'm going to tack w onto the end of v. V's terminal point, I'm going to start w there and go from there. So I'm going to take vector w and I'm going to start it right here. And then we're going to go to the right 2 and up 4 and we end there. So I took the vector and copied it here. And then what we find is our resultant vector is going to be this right here. If this is vector v and this is vector w, then this vector right here is v plus w. You basically take your two vectors that you're adding, place them on the end of each other, and connect the initial point of the first vector to the terminal point of the second vector, and this is the sum. If you recall from the last slide, our sum that we calculated algebraically was -1, 9, which is exactly what we've shown here. One way that you'll see people teach this is they'll teach you to create a parallelogram with your vectors. If I took vector v and copied it to right here, then we would create a parallelogram with our two vectors, and your resultant vector is going to be the diagonal of, or one of the diagonals of that parallelogram. So you might see it explained that way sometimes. But that's how you add vectors graphically. Let's look at how to subtract vectors graphically. So once again, I'm going to start with vector W. I'll do that one in purple this time. And then I've got vector V, which is negative 3, 5. And we're going to subtract these vectors this time. So we're doing W minus V. With subtraction, the order matters. Remember, with addition, the order doesn't really matter. With subtraction, our order matters. So I'm doing this vector minus this vector. The best way to think about this is that when we're subtracting, what we're really doing is we're really adding a negative. So I'm really doing vector W plus the opposite of vector V. And since we've already talked about scalar multiples, if you were to multiply vector V by a scalar multiple of negative 1, all that would do is it would take your vector from here and it would reflect it. So instead of going to the left 3 and up 5, it would go to the right 3 and down 5. And here would be our vector V. Then we can just worry about adding them. So remember, subtracting is just adding a negative. So as we learned on the last slide, what we're going to do is we're going to take our vector here and we're going to place its initial point on the terminal point of our first vector. And then once we've done that, we can see that our resultant vector will be right here. So if this is vector W and this is vector V that we subtracted, technically it's the opposite of V, right? This is the opposite of V. Then what we've created here is we've created W minus V. So W minus V in this case, this vector is going to have a horizontal component of 5 and it's going to have a vertical component of negative 1, which should be the same thing as what we got whenever we calculated it algebraically earlier. Now let's do a quick check for understanding. I want you to pause the video and I want you to try to do this one on your own. It actually combines two different ideas. So I'm going to work it out algebraically first and then we'll look at it graphically. If I take 3 times vector V, we know that 3V is going to be negative 3, 9. So we can take care of that scalar first. This part right here, that is our 3V, right? And then what we're going to do is we're going to do minus W. Well, recall, to subtract vectors, it's just like we're adding a negative. So it's like I'm going to add a negative 2 and a negative 5. Or you could think of it like a scalar of negative 1 is on vector V. And so then whenever I add these, we're going to have the resultant vector of negative 5, 4. That's our resultant vector. That is 3V minus W. Let's see if we get the same thing when we do it graphically. So I'm going to begin by just graphing vector V. Vector V had a horizontal component of negative 1 and a vertical component of 3, but then we multiplied that by a scalar of 3. So 3V is actually going to look right there. So there is our 3V vector. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our W vector. W would go to the right 2 and up 5, but we're actually adding the opposite of W because we're subtracting. So instead, I'm going to go to the left 2 and down 5. And so negative W would look like that. There is our negative W vector. And so our difference, our resultant vector after this operation is going to start at the initial point of the first vector and end at the terminal point of the second vector. So this is our 3V minus W right here. And as you can see, it has a horizontal component of negative 5 and a vertical component of 4. We got this graphically, but we could have done it algebraically also.